We just met, but sorry, I'm down with it. That's cool. So we don't wake up tomorrow morning and not know each other's names. I'm Eddie, the host of this party, and this is Alma Matters, where it matters just as much where you came from as what you do when you get here. Yeah, anywhere you go, people will do anything for their schools. But let's be honest, Philadelphia is one of those places, you don't need me to tell you, that we have something special between the colleges and universities here. And that's what we're bringing to the screen in the form of a game show with one winner in the end. We have a trophy, a studio audience here, by the way, which is today is made up mostly of our great Alma Matters team to give them a chance to root on their schools, just like you can at home. But really, we just did this so no Villanova kids would show up, to be honest with you. But anyway, before we go on, I have to do one thing for all of us, to bring up this girl that will be with me here each and every week, taking this journey with us to find out whose Alma Matters the most. Colorful commentator, gatekeeper to your standings, Temple, she's one of your own. Let her hear it one time in here. Give a warm Philadelphia welcome to the beautiful, lovely Rachel Keller.
Yay, so pumped, ready to go.
Don't start on me already about Temple beating St. Joe's this year.
Well, what color am I wearing, guys?
Okay.
What team is gonna win today? Let's go to you.
every week we'll be giving you guys two teams from the local schools. There's eight teams total in a running game show format. So there's not going to be one winner after every episode, but at the end of the whole season. Trophy will go to the winning team only to be displayed on their campus. Our first segment we have is called Tailgate, a physical challenge, which involves a little bit of backyard fun. For this challenge, each team member will have to make a cornhole shot. You're familiar with the game outside, you play outside of a bar or something like that. But this means either getting the beanbag in the hole or getting the beanbag to stay on the hole platform. Each team member will have to keep shooting until they make it. But here's the catch. Before each team member tosses the bag, they must spin around not once, not twice, not three, not four, five times using the dizzy bat. The tailgate challenge does not end until the time runs out or unless one team has made all of their cornhole shots. The team to win this challenge will get 50 points for every beanbag they get on the cornhole platform and 100 points for every beanbag that's made into the hole. All right? Tailgate challenge. Temp allows with Salle Explorers. Let's do it!
Let's go.
20th and oldie.
All right.
20th and oldie in the building right there. All right, so let's bring out the Temple Owls right now.
University! Fight! For the cherry and the what? For the cherry and the what? Fight! Woo! Yeah!
I should be starting to do this now because I am a hawk, but we'll let that go. All right. You guys know the deal, tailgate challenge, bean bags, dizzy bat, all that stuff in one. Ready?
Yeah,
let's go.
Do it.
All right, ready, set, go! They got it done first with 150 points. Let's get up for LaSalle. All right. Good job, boys. Nice. Good job, boys. Yeah.
We told you LaSalle was going to win.
What's up, Temple? You can't beat us.
We told you not to sleep on a small school like LaSalle. Let's go.
That scoreboard.
So after our first game, LaSalle is already that much closer to winning the trophy, which sits right over there. They have 150 points, Temple 100. So why don't we meet some of the contestants? What's your name? Why did you choose LaSalle?
My name is Amir Khan, and I chose LaSalle for their accredited business school and their smaller community, which I love a lot.
Cool.
My name's Ernie Volpe, and I chose LaSalle due, exactly like Amir said, the very small community, the small classes, the teachers are very hands-on, and the student body is very, very close.
Hi, I'm Tim. I chose LaSalle for the same reason, small classrooms. I also got a pretty good financial aid package, so that helped a lot.
Tim, let me ask you a question. When's the last time you've been that busy?
Last night.
Hey. There you go. All right, cool. So my producers hooked me up with a couple things that everybody at home might not know about you, but I do. So let's start with Ernie, who claims that he's perfected the rap of Nelly Furtado is promiscuous.
What?
Yeah, no, I'm serious, yeah.
It's true, it is true.
You know that you're gonna come on a game show, I'm gonna ask you to do that.
I don't know if there's time constraints on this.
No. Give us a little bit of it, come on. A little bit, let's go.
All right, the best line in the whole song, and it shows how dated the song is too, is it true, or are you talking trash? Is your game MVP like Steve Nash? 2006 NBA MVP, so. Little classic there.
What makes you the most qualified out of everybody in LaSalle to sing that song?
I have a voice that's a mixture of Fergie and Jesus.
There you go. Okay, that's good. There you go. All right, cool. So, Amir, actually, this might be just as interesting. You've played professional laser tag for 2 years.
Yes,
where
I
does
have.
That even happen?
I work at a place called Ultra Zone Laser Tag in Ben Salem, PA.
Shout out for Ben Salem.
Shout out for Ben Salem, right. Ben Salem High School, to the Owls. Not the Temple Owls. Ben Salem Owls, not the Temple Owls. I played in a professional league for 2 years, and I would say it's probably not what you think it is. It's a lot, it's very difficult.
What do you think that I think it is? I'm interested here.
A bunch of nerds shooting lasers everywhere.
I didn't say that, you did, I didn't say that.
But it's a fun time being a nerd and shooting lasers everywhere. So
the prize is what, pizza?
No, the prize is a big trophy, my man.
Okay, then there we go. That's good. Okay. So it wasn't what I thought it was. No. All right, cool. So, Tim, we have Tim here on this sheet that the producers gave me about being the fattest baby when he was 1 year old in his hometown. He won an award for this. You take it from here. Go ahead.
So every year my hometown, Norwood, has a 4th of July parade. And all the babies have different contests, like most patriotically dressed. And I happened to win first prize for fattest baby. Still have the blue ribbon and still have the $12 in prize money to this day.
You never spent the money?
No, never. No, never.
LaSalle has 3 L's in their name and they're about to get another one.
Yeah.
Y'all don't got this dancing skills.
Now we go to the Cherry and White, who need a little bit more fight next time, but that's okay. Everybody's here for the same prize in the end. Let's meet the team. Where are you from? Why'd you choose Temple? And your name.
How you doing?
My name's
Quash. Some know me as Bobby Brown. I chose Temple because it had a great chance to join my group, New Edition, and I love my major, advertising.
And where are you from?
I'm from Philadelphia.
Cool.
Straight from Philly.
My name's Talia. I'm also from Philly, and I chose Temple actually after transferring from LaSalle. But I chose Temple because it just seemed like a better option, a bigger community. I could expand and grow there, and that's what I'm doing.
My name's Jalil. I'm from Delaware, and grew up in Philly, moved to Delaware. And I chose Temple because I really wanted to get into the media industry, and Temple was like really big for that, so I had to make sure I was at Temple.
Well, you're a DJ.
Oh, yeah.
So.
And I DJ. Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah. I DJ.
I want a beat or something. Can you pick a something or what?
A beat? I can tell you some cool things I've done.
All right, let's roll with that.
I performed at A3C in Atlanta. I've opened up for Future at University of Delaware. I performed at like all the major spots in Philly. Union Transfer, Electric Factory, The Foundry. So yeah, I'm out here low-key.
All right, do you think Future and Designer sound too much alike or no?
So, about that.
About that, yeah.
Real quick.
If anybody doesn't
know,
Designer is the one who sings Panda, which is on the radio.
Right.
Well, it was on the radio. But.
Quick story. So when I opened up for Future, the one thing they told me that I could not play is Panda.
Really?
They legit told me I couldn't play Panda.
Why is that?
Because.
Just because of that?
Yeah, I guess because of that. Future didn't like Designer at that time.
All right. But yeah. I got you. So, Talia, I also understand that you helped to deliver 11 puppies.
I did, because I'm a saint, basically.
So how did that even come about? Like, why was there 11 puppies for you to deliver?
I took my puppy to North Carolina, and she got pregnant. And but we couldn't guess how many puppies she would have. We were like, oh, maybe four, maybe six. And then, you know, it was like 2 o'clock in the morning, and we were on the fifth puppy, and then another one came out, and then five more. So it was disgusting, but they're all alive and they're all great.
So if you have a moral to that story, what would it be?
Don't take your puppies to North Carolina, ever.
It's fair enough, yeah. So then we have Kalash, which I understand you also like to do cartwheels. Is that correct?
Yes.
You actually, that was your answer to this question. I want to make sure. No, I want to make sure. I'm kidding. It says.
Thank you.
Second round, you have a mind challenge with. I'll be asking some trivia based on your school's history, some famous alumni who have attended your school, and also just some regular Philadelphia trivia in general. Once I ask the question, either contestant can buzz in to answer for 50 points. After each question is asked, the team will rotate members. So each team member will answer two questions each, adding up to 6 questions total. Ms. Keller, if I had to ask you, who was your favorite person who graduated from Temple University, you would say what?
I have 3, actually.
3, okay.
Okay, two people I interned for, cool kids, not even kids, what? Cool dudes, Quincy Harris, host of The Q, he's an alumni. Okay. Solomon Jones, host of WRD on Word Radio, my second favorite, actually, they're tied. And Tamron Hall, of course, who just left NBC.
First question. What second, you have to wait till I finish the buzzing. Cool. What second lady received her master's degree in education from Westchester University?
Woo!
What do you got?
Michelle Obama.
No, second lady we're looking for. Second lady. Chance? Time.
Yeah,
we gotta move on. Answer was Jill Biden. Next.
Let's go. Next question.
Jill Biden. Not Joe, Jill.
Oh, Jill. Okay, go. Next question.
What Temple University graduate went on to become a comedian, Full House father, and original host of America's Funniest Home Videos? I'm gonna give that one to Temple.
Bob Saget.
You got that right.
Yep. Bob Saget. Next question. Let's go.
The Villanova University graduate here played 13 seasons in the NFL for the Oakland LA Raiders. Name the co-host of Fox NFL Sunday. LaSalle.
Howie Long.
You got it. Yep. Good.
Oh, nice. What's next, Eddie?
Good. What Temple University graduate also started as a stand-up comic before landing television roles on shows such as I Spy and You Bet Your Life? Go.
Bill Cosby.
You got it. Good.
Woo! It was Bill Cosby.
Meinhard Frank Robb earned an MBA from Drexel University before being hired as a salesman. He's most remembered for playing the Munchkin Corner in what 1939 classic film? Pull the trigger, LaSalle. Come on. All right, go ahead.
Time.
Okay, Chance.
Coroner?
Munchkin Coroner. All right, we gotta move on. Wizard of Oz.
It was Wizard of Oz.
That's the only movie with Munchkins. Come on, guys.
But he said quarter.
Yeah.
Let's go. I only watched Quarter.
What musical duo met as students at Temple University and went on to write hits such as Rich Girl and Maneater? Temple.
No Doubt. No.
LaSalle.
Hal Notes.
Hall, but we'll give it to you. All right, cool. Yeah. All right.
Whoa, LaSalle.
That's the end of the trivia round for now. Rach, what do we have for the score?
Let's see here. Temple, we have 200 points. And LaSalle, we have 250 points.
Yeah.
LaSalle is in the
take your seats. We can begin right now. kids these days just don't get it. They don't think like me. Kids these days just don't get it. They don't take life seriously.
All right, guys, for the final event, we have the karaoke challenge. In this challenge, each team has 1 minute to sing a song. Each player on the team must sing one third of the song. So once the first player on your team has sang 20 seconds, you'll hear my buzzer, and that means you need to pass the mic on to the next player. Whoever sings and performs the best will earn 100 points to their score. Let's begin. All right, who's up first? Who's up first? Who's up first? Are we gonna do couple first? Let's do it, LaSalle, LaSalle. Step on up here, guys. Woo! Let's go. All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds, remember, you're gonna hear this. Right. You need to pass it on to the next person, all right? Ready? Let's go. Ready, set, and go.
Wouldn't it be nice if we were older? Then we wouldn't have to wait so long. And wouldn't it be nice to live together in the kind of world where we belong?
You know it's gonna make it that much better when we can say goodnight and stay together. Wouldn't it be nice if we could wake up in the morning when the day is new?
Sad you're spending the day together. Just show your clothes the whole night through. Happy times together.
Let's go, clap, guys, let's go.
I wish that every kiss was never ending. Wouldn't it be nice?
All right, all right. Good job, boys. Nice. All right. Let's see if Temple can do what LaSalle just did. You ready? On your mark, set, go.
While we kissed, I fell under your spell. No one could deny, don't you ever say. I just walked away.
I will always want you. I can't live a lie, running for my life. I always want you. I came in like a wrecking ball.
Okay? If you guys think LaSalle won that, give him a hand. Give him a hand. All right. If you guys think Temple won that, give him a hand. All right, it looks like we're adding some points onto the board. Let's see. 300 points. Temple's in the lead now. Let's move on to the next game.
Final challenge. Temple is up 300 to 250. The last game is called Color Copy. So think Color Simon Says, Copy. That game that we all play when we were younger. I'm gonna read out a couple colors. You guys have to get them exactly right in the sequence, one after each other. And it's worth 50 points if you get them all correct. Nothing for partial. Good? Got it?
Got it.
Let's do it. First up, Sal. Good?
Okay.
Be after me. You good?
I'm good.
Red, orange, yellow, black, white.
Red, orange, yellow, black, white.
Good. Okay. Apple. Green, blue, purple, brown, gold. Good. Okay, Sal. Gray, aqua, lime, navy, cyan. Pink, purple.
Gray, aqua, lime, navy, cyan, purple.
Pink, purple. That's all right. Temple, you ready? Teal, indigo, coral, fuchsia, salmon, red, blue.
Teal, indigo, coral, fuchsia, salmon, red, blue.
Got it, go. Yeah. Olive, ochre, tan, wheat, violet, red. Orchid tan. If you can tell me what that is, I'll give you another 50 points.
What is an orchid tan? Anyone know what an orchid tan is?
No, I don't. Alright, Temple, ready? Pink, snow, aquamarine, beige, bisque, red, yellow.
Pink, snow, aquamarine, beige, bisque, yellow.
Red, yellow.
Red, yellow.
It's alright.
Alright. Last one. LaSalle. Red, green, gray, teal, olive, yellow, green.
Red, green, gray, teal, olive, yellow, green.
That's it. Good.
All right.
That's it. So we're going to go to a score update. Rach, tell us what we got for the end of the game.
This is the end of the game, guys. You see right here that we have a clear winner. We have LaSalle over here with 350 points, and we have our Temple Owls. Yeah!